When printing 3D lithophanes, it's recommended that we print them upright to ensure that our print has as much detail as possible. If we were to print them flat against the printer bed, they lose a lot of detail, which is what makes them so fascinating. But doing so presents an architectural problem. Anything this thin and this tall has a hard time supporting itself. This set of six lithophanes printed together did a pretty good job on their own, along with the support around the bottom, which is called a brim, which we'll talk about in just a second. This print on the left, however, didn't work so well and ended up with a bend in it. And this one was just a pure disaster. It couldn't even finish printing. During the process, one on the left started listing to the side, and in order to compensate, the printer tried its best to keep going in a straight line, but ultimately ended up creating a giant arc and then just went off the rails. When this happens, it can be a huge frustration, as well as a waste of time and material. I created a solution to this problem, and in this video I'm going to walk you through that process so that all of your lithophanes turn out straight, clean, and consistent. Also, I've put a link to that STL file that I use in the video, so you don't need to build one yourself, and can simply load the file into Cura and support your lithophanes. Before we get started, let's do a quick rundown of the most common supports that are generally used for a 3D print. They are referred to as a skirt, a raft, and a brim. Skirts don't offer much real support, or any real support. They're primarily used to clear your printer's nozzle and test the bed's levelness. A raft is a multi-layer base that sits under your print. They provide good bed adhesion, but need to be removed from the finished print, which can be difficult. A brim is a single layer support that surrounds the print but doesn't go underneath it. It provides bed adhesion without any removal needed, and this is recommended for supports of our lithophanes. Cura also has tower supports for this kind of problem, but we don't want any support touching our image surface, so instead let's just build our own. You can skip this first step if you'd like, because I've provided the STL file in the description, but here's what I did. In Rhino, I navigate to solid and make a simple closed shape box. Once it's built, I'm going to adjust its scale to make it 6 inches high. Then I export it as an STL and save it on my desktop. Now I open up Ultimaker Cura and import my four lithophanes by selecting File, Open Files. These are the same tall files that had trouble printing before. They all open up right next to one another, and the first thing I want to do is rotate them 90 degrees so that the long side is flush with the print bed. This way they'll still be printing upright, but they'll have a larger surface area touching the print bed and will be less tall overall, which was the problem to begin with. For this, I'll use my rotate tool, shortcut R. Make sure you have snap rotation selected to ensure that they move in easily controlled increments. Next, I'll use my move tool, shortcut T, and move them so that they're aligned on the left side of the bed. Since I created a support that will prop the prints up from behind, I'm once again going to use my rotate tool to rotate two of them 180 degrees so that we have two sets of prints that face each other back to back, allowing us to use the same support to prop up each pair. Now I bring my support in by selecting again File, Open Files, and choose the support. We can see that it's not quite as tall as our lithophanes, so I select the object and use my scale tool to enlarge them so that they're just about the same height as my lithophanes. Make sure you have uniform scaling on and the entire object will scale up. Now I go down to my object list and highlight my support. Right click, choose Multiply Selected, and enter 3. Now that we have all four supports visible, I'm going to line them up in pairs. So I'll move them over to the right side of the print bed, and I want to find a spot on the y-axis that is towards one side of the lithophanes, and then on the x-axis to an approximate spot on the right side of the bed. Here at about 75 point something something millimeters looks good. So now that it's an approximate space, I'm going to move over to my x-axis entry and enter a whole number, and 80 seems appropriate because it's close. This makes it easier to move the second support. Now I go to my second support, choose 80 on the x-axis as well, and set the y-axis to an approximate spot on the opposite side of the lithophanes. Using my rotate tool again, I will rotate each support on the blue or z-axis by 30 degrees. Now I can just move my lithophanes over so that a pair sits back to back again with the supports in between them. Because we turn the supports by 30 degrees, we ensure that only the smallest surface area is touching the back of the lithophanes, which makes it easier to remove after we're done printing. When setting the placement, we're looking for the lithophanes and the supports to touch each other in the smallest manner possible so that they're only barely together. Again, this will help ensure that the removal at the end is easy. And we can do the same for the next pair. We navigate around them to make sure that our surfaces are touching, but only slightly. Now we're ready to go ahead and slice our objects, save them as G-code, and send them to the printer. Here's what they look like after printing. When looking from the inside, we can tell that the supports are hardly even touching the print. We can even see light passing through the seams. This is exactly what I want. That tiny bit of support is enough to stabilize the prints and also ensure that they easily snap right off. And that's it. Thanks for watching.